Of Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen. I want to welcome you. Thank you for coming. Thank you. Thank you for coming. First timers, thank you. And I really appreciate you for joining us once again. God bless you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you so much, my dear friend. Thank you. Jesus is Lord. Today, we will negotiate. We are going to do negotiation prayer of deliverance. Yes, we are going to negotiate the prayer of deliverance. That's why this subject is called, how this subject is called. The topic is called, hallelujah, praise be the name of Jesus. Ha, Jesus is good. Deliverance, spiritual warfare, prayer is very hard, it's very difficult, it's just fighting, it's war, it's not easy. We will fight because you make the demon to manifest, you make witches to start following you, you make wizards, you make your cult, you make everybody, you make more enemy than good people. So spiritual warfare is war. That's why you see they try to attack the computer, they try to attack everything. They try to spell and chant. They know this time I'm coming. They will work hard to bring destruction. But never the rest. Jesus Christ is Lord and King of Kings. He never lose any battle. He won the battle. He was able to defeat the enemy. And the enemy is in our feet. Whether the devil like it or not, Jesus Christ is Lord and King of Kings. I want to thank God for what he has done to our life and what he has done to your life. He is God of gods and the King of glory. We want to thank him so much and we give the glory and the honor. Raise up your hand and thank God and say, God, thank you. Thank you because you are so good. You are so wonderful. There is no one like you. If God is like me or like you, some of you could not let them even to come near. But God loves us the way we are. He doesn't care. God loves the way we are. Even if, what, because he's your creator, he's your father. Since he's your father, he loves you the way you are. The only thing God does not love is when you worship the idol. When you worship the idol, God become against you. God cannot love you that way. He loves you so much, but the moment you turn to idol, God will not love, he will never love you. The more you start worshiping the other gods, now God is not going to love you at all because you become an enemy. But our Father loves you. When we call upon his name, he will come and answer us. When we need anything, he will come and help us. That's why we are going to negotiate prayer of deliverance. We need to talk to God. We need to appeal to him. We need to negotiate with him. The way people negotiate in the Bible. Let's go straight away to the word of God. Let's pray. My Father, in the name of Jesus, I welcome you to this the word. I invite you to in this word, God. My Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, let this word enter into your people, my Father. Tonight, Father, deliver your people through your word, oh my God. In the beginning was the word, and the word was God. My Father, you are the word. Yourself, you are the word. Therefore, I come to you with this word, God, to release to your people, my Father, and your people will be free as they will hear this word, God. My Father, I want to thank you and praise your name and say, God, my Father, deliver your people. Deliver your people, Lord. Let your people open their mouth. Let their people open their mind. Let your people open their ways so that you can deliver them, God, my Father. Anything that is holding them, they have no idea. They don't know what it is. But God, you know, my Father, deliver them. Father God, in the name of Jesus, what your people are going through, tonight, Father, remember them. and deliver them, God, my Father. The situation that they are facing tonight, God, my Father, have mercy upon them. Like the way you had mercy of that man called Bartimaeus, son of the Mayo, who called you in his time of desperate, when he was a poor and a blind man. He didn't have anything, but he called upon you, Jesus, and Jesus, you stopped everything you were doing, and you called him. Tonight, God, let your people, hear your people, my Father. Hear their cry. Hear their distress. Hear their depressed. Hear their problem, God. Hear what they are doing tonight, Lord, my Father. I am representing them to you. And Father God, answer their prayer in the mighty name of Jesus. Lord, my Father, any power, anything that is holding their prayer, anything that is working against their life, let them be destroyed in the name of Jesus. God, my Father, in the name of Jesus, I bring the any evil powers, anything, powers of darkness that is following them and blocking their ways, Lord, let them be destroyed in the name of Jesus. I bind every movement of the devil, destruction of the enemy, to be defeated and be disgraced in the name of Jesus. My God and my Father, I breathe the blood of Jesus over this prayer once again, and I cover this prayer with the precious blood in the mighty name of Jesus. Any evil child of the devil assigned to bring destruction and destruction to this prayer, my God, my Father, scatter them. Scatter them, scatter them, scatter them. Remove them and scatter them in the mighty name of Jesus. Lord, I want to thank you. I want to praise your name, God, and give you all the glory. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, I pray. Amen. Thank you once again. This is your host, Prophetess Dr. Christine Siki. Welcome you. I'm going to talk to you the subject called Negotiation Prayer of Deliverance. Negotiation Prayer of Deliverance. These are the prayer men of God, the prophet of God, Jeremiah prayed. Jeremiah prayed the prayer of negotiation of deliverance. Let's look from the book of Jeremiah 10 verse 23 to 25. The book of Jeremiah 23 to 25. The book of Jeremiah 10, 23 to 25. Sometimes I say the scripture and it is very clear written there, but I don't know why I just found it. I can't say it properly. But I thank the Lord that I have to stop this and command anything that wants to twist me or to blind or anything that they are working which is not from God, I destroy them. Many times I see, I write the scripture right on the computer, even on the paper. Now when I start reading or when I start talking, I found that I'm mentioning a wrong scripture. But that's not right. I am praying that anything that brings confusion shall be destroyed in the name of Jesus. I am going to read from the book of Jeremiah 10, verse 23 to 25. The Bible says, I know, O Lord, that the way of man is not himself. That it is not in a man who walks to direct his steps. Jeremiah is praying, saying that he knows the way of the man. He knows a man. I know, O Lord, that the ways of a man is not himself. The ways of a man is not himself. You know, the man may plan so many plans, but God is the one to direct them. The man thinks different, and the way they see things is not himself. It is either God or the demons that has made this person to act like the way he's acting. So Jeremiah says, I know the ways is not for man. It's for the enemy. It's for the devil. You find a person, very good person, very gentle person, but the way he's doing things is contrary, is out of order. Now the Bible says, correct me, O Lord, but in justice, not in your anger, lest you bring me into nothing. So Jeremiah has given himself to God. Negotiating to God, he said, God, I know I'm a human being. I'm not perfect. Please correct me in love. Correct me in justice. Don't correct me in anger. When God corrects you in anger, he will destroy you. So Jeremiah was negotiating to God and asking God to correct him in justice. Now you need to ask God to correct you. Maybe you don't know what you have done, or you don't know what is holding your problem. Ask God. Ask God, Father, correct me in justice. Correct me in love. Don't correct me in anger. Because if God corrects you in anger, that problem will not go. Look at the book of Deuteronomy 28, verse 15 to 66. There are some curses God himself curses people, because people have turned themselves to worship idols, turned themselves to worship other gods. So God does not want that. God has gone as far bringing our Lord Jesus Christ to die for us, so that whosoever believe in him will not be perished but have eternal life. But still, people, they don't want to do that. So when God wants to correct you in anger, he will discipline you. You know, some people, they get salvation hard time. You've been given time to repent and ask God to give you to deliver you, but you don't want to do that. Now, there was a man. My spiritual father was mentioning this. This man, God called him to go and preach some another town. Even not this man. Let's say Jonah. Jonah, God called him to go to deliver the message in Nineveh. But Jonah says, no, I'm not going there. I better go somewhere else. Jonah went and bought a ticket with his own money and bought a sheep. And they started running away because he was avoiding God. What God did, he disciplined him. God made us a fish and swallowed him. And Jonah suffered in this fish for 3 days and for 3 nights. That terrible pain, that pain that you are going through, yeah, could be God is correcting you in anger, but you don't understand. So today you need to understand that God will correct you in justice and love, but not in anger. If God correct you in anger, you will suffer and pain and cry. It is serious. Don't wait God to correct you in anger. Because our God, he can discipline. He's your father, and he knows how to discipline his children. Don't wait for him to discipline you, because his pain is very hard. It's very pain. If you want God to discipline you, don't wait. Just give yourself to him and say, here I am. I am God. Please don't do that. Then God, our God is good. He loves us. And he will correct you in justice, not in anger. This is what Jeremiah understood God. Jeremiah understand God very well. How God can change. Yeah? How God can come and really become very violent to the people who does not worship him. Look at that. Look at Jesus, what he was doing. Jesus was very violent. Jesus went to the church and beat people at the age of 12, and they turned the chairs up and down, and they ran people out. He was a boy, but what he did very aggressive. And if it is today, he could have been arrested and taken to mental hospital. Yeah? Because they will say, this child is mad, he's sick. Why is it beating people doing things like this? We are selling water in the church. We are selling things. We are selling Bible. We are selling things in the church. We are doing business. Why are you acting like that? Yeah? So, and this is New Testament. It's not Old Testament. But you see people, they are still doing the same thing. So when the wrath of God will come in the church, it will discipline them with the anger. So we don't need that. The Bible says that in the verse 5, verse 25, the Bible says, boil out your wrath on the nations that know you not, and on the people that call not your name. For they have devoured Jacob, they have devoured him and consumed him, and have laid a waste his habitation. Now here, Jeremiah is asking to destroy and punish the nation that does not know God. They have refused God. And see, this nation, they have destroyed Jacob. Jacob means Israel. They are destroying Israel. Now, and God is going to discipline such a nation because they are destroying Israel. For example, this people who does not worship God, who are destroying Canada or destroying America. So Lord would discipline them because they are already, if something happened to America, innocent people, they are the victims. Somebody who will do something and they met people to suffer and die, and this person is the one who has done this. Now it happened. The children of Israel suffered. The children of Israel were in bondage for 400 years because of the wrath of God. Yeah? And now, and Jeremiah was telling God, please discipline the nation, discipline people who does not worship, who does not know you. Already, some of them, they have made the children of Israel to suffer. When Pharaoh started making the children of Israel, he made them so much. He made them hard labor. He disciplined them. He did all evil so that he can destroy them. But God did not want the children of Israel to be punished. But he said, okay, enough is enough. Now I will deliver you. The Lord delivered them. So wherever you are going through, what you are going through, turn to God. Cry to God. No matter what you have done. A woman was crying nonstop. She said that she has aborted so many children, so she doesn't think God can forgive her. And she feels that she has sinned, she cannot be forgiven. Some people, they tell me that God cannot forgive me. I've done a lot of sin. I've done a lot of bad stuff. God, still the mercy of God is in the throne. If you talk to him, you negotiate with God, he will deliver you. That's why we have this prayer of deliverance, negotiation prayer of deliverance. God will hear you from his throne and heal you and deliver you in the mighty name of Jesus. You see, yes, we thank God that God is going to help you and deliver you as he said in his word. Don't wait, don't be wasted. Don't let God be wasted. Don't let your house be desolate. In Africa, there was a family, they were wept, all of them, they died. They were left the children. The place was closed down. This disease is called AIDS. It affected their family. Everybody, almost the whole clan died. I was having a children's home. So this children's home, we were told that there's a children who are abandoned there, and they were going to the extended family, who they call grandpa, and this grandpa was so wicked. When these children went there, they were almost 13 children. The youngest was 2 years. The youngest was 2 years, and she was also having HIV AIDS. Now, the older child was like, it was like 9, 10 years. And the man had 3 wives, and they bring the woman, and now AIDS came and wept them and killed them. And then the uncle, and so many people died from this disease called HIV AIDS. That was 1985. People, they were not aware of AIDS. People were dying and they didn't know what to do. So what happened, when we went to get these children from that home, the father, the grandpa, was sleeping with that girl, a girl of 9 years or 12 years, because she was pregnant at very underage. So the child was depressed, was suffered enough, tortured, and the family, the extended family from a distance, they came home and steal everything from home. So the children were abandoned, and the place was left wasted, as the Bible says. So I am not judging them, but the word of God is very clear. It says that wherever you start worshiping other gods, you don't worship in God, then you will be wasted. You will be, no matter your degrees you have, you will be wasted. So it's your turn to negotiate with God and tell God, before you come to me, before anything happened to me, even though it is already there, please help me and deliver me and let me talk to you, God, so that you can forgive me, because your mercy is still forever and is still there. You can help me. Then God will help you in Jesus' name. When we look at the Bible from the book of Hallelujahs, the book of Matthew, the book of Matthew 26 verse 39, Matthew 26 verse 39, thank you, Jesus. Yes, Lord, I thank you. Matthew 26 verse 39, the Bible says, "And going a little farther, he fell on his face and prayed, saying, My Father, if it is possible, let this cup pass from me. Nevertheless, not as I will, but as you will." This is the Son of God, Jesus Christ, who went to his Father. He prayed and said, "Please, God, take this cup away. But if it is your will, let your will to be done, not my will." Yes? "Not my ways. Let your ways be done." So let's give God his way to be done in your life. Don't do things by yourself. Let God himself lead you. There was this man in the Bible called Prophet Hosea. Prophet Hosea. This prophet, God told him to go and marry a prostitute. He didn't refuse. He said, "God, I am a prophet. Why do you want me to marry a prostitute? Does it mean there's no women? Does it mean there's no virgin women that I can marry? God, are you sure you want me to do so?" God said, "Yes, go ahead. I want you to marry this woman to get me children. To get the children, I'll name them." So, Hosea went ahead and married this woman. The woman was a very high prostitute. And the woman was with Hosea, and still she was doing prostitution. That is a very serious thing. But Hosea negotiated with God and said, "God, you want me to marry a prostitute? Are you serious, God?" God said, "Yes." So now, when Jesus went to God, he prayed prayed so many times. He went there and prayed, and said, "Now, Lord, let your will to be done." He prayed and negotiated to God and asking God. If you look at this, he said, when he was talking to God, he said, "And my Father, it is my Father, if it be possible, let this cup pass from me." So he was negotiating to God. He was saying, "My Father, if it is possible, please, let this cup be passed away. Let this cup be removed from me. I don't want this. It is too much." Because Jesus has foreseen what is going through, how he's going to be persecuted, how he's going to suffer, how he's going to be beaten. He saw this. Now, you also, right now where you are, you have been suffering the same suffering Jesus went through. The same punishment Jesus went through, you are still going, even when Jesus has paid for you. When you are going through that pain, that sickness, that problem, poverty activator, yeah, you are working, you are doing everything, but still you are under a poverty activator. The enemy is activating you with poverty. You are still struggling, yeah. You want to be married, but no man has even approached you. You have never talked to any, nobody is interested with you. Yeah? So you say, "God, my Father, what can I do now? What is this, God, my Father? Remove this singlehood from me. Remove this, if God, I want you to take away this singlehood from me. Take away this poverty from me. Take it away, God. It is not your will. But let your will to be done so that I can be wealthy as according to your word." So you talk to God like that. It's not the will of God for you to be poor. It's not the will of God for you to be single. It's not the will of God to be barrenness. It's not the will of God for miscarriaging. You know, people are suffering. People are looking for children. And some people are doing abortion. It's not the will. It's not the will of God. It's the will of the enemy. So you have to negotiate and say, God, it's not your will for me to be barrenness, for me to be poor, for me to go to not to have a job. It's not your will. The will of God is very positive, not negative. So, because God has planned that Jesus will pay for us, will pay for us, everything for us. So Jesus said, although it's very difficult, it's a hard time, but I want you, let your will to be done. Now, cover me, God. Help me, God. And God did so. Hallelujah. So you have to negotiate with God. You have to pray. Jesus prayed. A prophet of God, Jeremiah, prayed. He prayed so much. So we have to pray. If you don't want to pray, you want the pastors to pray for you, you are doing zero work. I am a teacher. You know, I used to teach and I'm a teacher. So when I give you 25%, 75% is yours. That's what we have. All teachers, that's what they give students or children. You don't need a teacher to give you everything. I give you, I teach you, I give you the way to do, and then the rest, you are the one to do it. When I pray for you so that you can continue praying after I left you. You don't have to worry me to call me all the time. Pray for me. You call me 100 times. You know, some people, they stay in the phone. They call me throughout the night. They want me to put off the phone to block other people. So I said, you call, but I can't be praying for you every minute, every time. That is a lie. Yeah? So we have to talk. You know how to present yourself to God himself. When I ask people, you can pray for me, you can call for me to pray for you, it doesn't mean that you can call me 100 times in a day. Some people, they are like that. Yeah. So my God will help you in Jesus' name. So let us negotiate God for deliverance. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. Lord, I thank you. Yes. Yes. We are going to see the book of I'm going to look for the book called 1 Chronicles 4:10. 1 Chronicles 4:10. The Bible says, Jabez called upon the Lord of Israel, saying, O Lord, that you could bless me and enlighten my border, and that your hand might be with me, and that you may keep me from harm, so that it might not bring me a pain. And God grant what he asked. You see, Jabez, he prayed to God. He asked him, please, God, I know that my name is a bad name. I know that, God, I this name is going to bring me pain. It's going to bring me sorrow. It's going to bring me a pain. Please, please, God, help me. Help me, deliver me. And God gave him what his desire. If you look at the book of Psalms 37, verse 1 to 5, the Bible says, God will give you the desire of your heart. The desire of your heart, what your heart wants is what God can give you. Now, when Jabez realized that there is a problem with his name, there is a problem that has caused him, so he said, oh God, my Father, deliver me, God. Let me look at King James. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. God is good. Thank you, Jesus. You are wonderful. Yes, Lord, my Father. In the name of Jesus. The Bible says here in the book of King James fashion, the Bible says, 1 Chronicles 4:10. The Bible says, here he said, and Jabez called on the Lord of Israel, saying, oh, that thou wouldest bless me indeed, and enlarge my coast, and that thy hand might be with me, and thou wouldest keep me from evil, that it may not grieve me. And God granted him that which he requested. So God requested God requested God to help him to change. Hallelujah. You can negotiate with God. You can talk to God. You can tell God, I don't want this name. Change it for me. Bless me indeed. I don't want this. Because I know you. Some of your names, you don't know if that name is the cause of your problem. It's the one which brings you problem. You have no idea what your name means. You don't know if your name is called devil or is called snake. Or is giving the devil to come to you because you are honing their name. Or your name is calling devil. Devil, come. So the devil will come. Or your name is calling demon, come and leave. Demon, come and leave. So your name can call demon, and that is your name. When you are called, you are telling the demon, come and leave. You don't know your name. So like this man, he had to cry to God and ask God, please help me. That's what he says. Oh, that you would bless me and enlarge my boat, that and that your hand might be with me, and that you would keep me from harm, so that it might not bring me pain. And God grant what he asked. God grant what he asked. God give him what he asked. God is going to give you what you are asking. God is going to give you everything you have been asking. God is going to give it to you. As you believe in him and you call it on him, you negotiate it to him, he will come to you and give you what you have been looking for. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. Lord, I want to thank you, Father, that you are going to deliver your people in the name of Jesus. So we are going to look in the book of Genesis 32. Genesis 32, verse 9 to 12. Here is another man who knows how to negotiate with God. He said, okay, I have to talk to you. I know my mistakes. I've made a mistake like any other human being. But God, you are full of mercy. You cannot leave me in this situation, in this problem. So he went ahead and negotiated with God, and God delivered him. Let's look at the book of Genesis 32, verse 9. And Jacob said, O God of my father Abraham and God of my father Isaac, O Lord, who said to me, return to your country and to your kindred, and I may do you good. I am not worthy of the least of all the deeds of steadfast love and all the faithfulness that you have shown to your servant, for with only my staff I closed this Jordan, and now I have become two camps. Please deliver me from the hand of my brother, Esau, for I fear him, that he may come and attack me, the mothers with the children. But you said, I will surely do you good and make your offspring as the sand of the sea, which cannot be numbered for multitude. Now, here, Jacob was negotiating to God, reminding to God. When Jacob was talking to God, he told God what he did to his brother. He told God that, God, I know that God, I know my brother, if he found me, he would kill me because I messed with him. You promised that, God, you would protect me and my children, and my children will be blessed like sand. Now, God, if Esau would be angry and go to attack the mothers and the children and kill them, then my offspring will not be sand like what you promised. So, God, Father, I know that you are my father of Abraham, my father of Isaac. My father, please, please do me a favor. Don't let my brother destroy my family. And God granted him. God softened the heart of Esau when he went there, and Jacob was delivered from the hands of his brother. So God is going to deliver you today, wherever you did, any sin, anything you have done, you negotiate with God, talk to him, he will forgive you and deliver you. God is able. God is merciful. Look at what Jacob did to his brother. Jacob messed up. Jacob did evil than good. He was deceived his brother. And he ran away. He went to stay with his uncle. Uncle was more criminal than Jacob. He made Jacob to suffer, and they worked him and reduced his wages 10 times. But Jacob was smart and changing the ships and doing everything because God was with him. Now, Jacob, this man was more criminal. The Laban was more criminal than Jacob. He was a thug. And he made Jacob to work so hard. And Jacob was working because that's the only way he could survive. And he twisted the women Jacob, the woman Jacob wanted to marry. Jacob didn't want to have two women, but because of what the father-in-law did, he twisted and gave him a long woman. So Jacob said, I did not want this woman, but because you have done this, let me have them, both of them sisters. And one was a witch, and one was a godly woman. So you can still talk to God, negotiate to God, and God will help you. God is massive God. No matter what you have done, anything you have done, you know, your conscience still you remind, God is going to deliver you. God loves you. God, talk to him. Even me, I talk to him. I ask him, I request him, I negotiate with him. There's a time you need to negotiate with God. You just sit down and negotiate. There's a time you pray a prayer of negotiation that would deliver you from the problem that you are facing. I pray that God Almighty will deliver you tonight. Go ahead and pray and ask God to deliver you because it is his will for you to be set free, for you to come out from that box you have been in. You fear, you stay in one place, you don't want to move because you fear people are following you, something is not right, you've been changing jobs, you have been changing place to place, you have been going all the states, you have been wandering all the states, you have been wandering country to country, but you have never rest. You need to rest and sit down and negotiate with God. God will help you. Even the business you are doing, you change this, you do this, you are trying everything. God is going to deliver you. Negotiate with God. If it is ancestral power that is holding your business, that is holding your ministry, negotiate with God. Tell Jesus that, Jesus, you paid the price, the curses you break, it is over. Let me be free. Let me be free like Jabez, the way Jabez prayed. Like Jesus, he prayed too. Jeremiah prayed. He asked God a deliverance prayer. So God granted them wherever they were praying. So the same God, the Bible says, is the same God today and forever. He doesn't change. The same God who delivered Jabez, who delivered Jesus, who delivered Jeremiah, who delivered this man called Jacob. He's the same God who can deliver you. He doesn't change. That's a goodness. The Bible is assuring us that our Father, who is the same God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, is the same God that we can go to him and he will hear our prayer and he will hear our prayer and he will deliver us. So go ahead and pray that God will help you. Father, in the name of Jesus, I bring your people into your hand, God. Anybody who is confused, who does not know what prayer he can pray or what prayer she can pray or what a kind of prayer that they can talk to you so that you can hear. My God, even though they don't know how to pray, Father, help them, deliver them, my God. Hear their prayer, God. Look at their situation they are going through. My God, my Father, in the name of Jesus, deliver them, Lord. First, help them, God, my Father, in the mighty name of Jesus. Evil around them, all powers of darkness surrounding them, let them be destroyed in the name of Jesus. All dark cloud that is covering them, let this dark cloud be removed from them in Jesus' name. All those witchcraft following them, let this witchcraft suffer and be wasted. According to your word, it says, suffer not a witch to live, God. All the wicked people that is attacking you attacking them, Lord, remove them. Remove them, my Father and my God, in the name of Jesus. Deliver them, God Almighty, King of Glory. My Father and my God, in the name of Jesus. The evil people that is around them, the satanic messenger, satanic priest that has been assigned by the devil to come and deceive them and destroy them. Father, deliver them. Deliver your people, my God. Deliver them from the hands of the enemy. Deliver them from evil and from wicked power of the enemy, God, my Father, in the mighty name of Jesus. Lord, I want to thank you and bless your name and give you all the glory, God. Thank you, Heavenly Father, for you will never change and you are the same today forever. You love your people. You love us the way we are. Lord, my Father, in the name of Jesus, we ask you because you are our Father, you will hear our prayer. My God, thank you, Father. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord Almighty, King of Glory. Father God, in the name of Jesus, those who are struggling for finances, Lord, my Father, grant them finance. You are a God of mysterious breakthroughs. Lord, my Father, you are the owner of silver and gold. You are mysterious miracles, God. You make miracles where there is no miracle. You are a God who provides where there is no way. You provide where there is no way. When you rain manna from heaven, manna were coming and you feed the children of Israel on the wilderness 40 years. No one lack. No one was sick. No one's clothes were worn out. No one's shoes were big or small. You are a God of miracles. God of miracles and signs and wonders. You are the same God that you would make this family who are crying, who have no hope, who have lost everything. Their houses is gone. These things are at risk. They have no money to pay. They have nothing. They are homeless. God deliver them. Provide their way. Provide their promotion. Somebody has been fired. Father, you are the person does not have a job. They are crying. You are a God of promotion. Promote this person to another level so that he can get a better job than what he has been fired. People are suffering. Some people are mourning. Some people are crying. Some people have lost their beloveds. Some people are on pains. Some all of them, they are in labor. Father God, hear them and deliver them. Those are fighting. Those family are fighting. Husband and wife, they don't talk. They are fighting. Lord, forgive them and reconcile them. Bring restoration to them. Those one who have lost their husband have run to other men or to other women. Lord, my Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, restore the marriage back in Jesus' name. My God and my Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, Lord, I pray that the sickness that your people are, some of your people having, terrible, crippled sickness, multiple sickness, Father, I pray deliver them. I cast those sickness from their midst in Jesus' name. I pray that God deliver them. Deliver your people, my Father, in the mighty name of Jesus. Lord, I want to thank you, Father. I want to give you the glory, God. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, I pray. Amen. Thank you very much. God bless you so much. See you tomorrow at the same time, midnight, 12 midnight. We are on. So I might come during the day to pray with you. So God bless you so much. This is your host, Prophetess Dr. Christine Isiki, saying bye-bye to you. Remember to call our prayer, our phone, and also go to our website. You can go to our website to help yourself. There is a lot of materials, videos are there, and you can learn a lot. There's a lot of videos. You can go there and look for months. Since we started this prayer, it's almost 1 year now. So you can go and look from month and all, most subjects that are there, it will help you. Your life will never be the same again. Thank you very much. If you need help, you need guidance, you need me to help you, I am here to help you. I am here to stand with you, to pray with you. Our number is 647-208-5207. Call me, I will stand with you and pray with you. If you need someone to agree with you, here I am, I will pray with you. And we have toll-free number 877-241-3420. People without long distance, you can use this number, it's free. We are paying for you. So you just call that number, we will respond. And also we have another number. If the other one is engaged, you can call 905-487-7196. These numbers, they are there for you to help you, and we can reach you and help you. So call me. I will come and help you. God bless you so much. Don't forget to go to our website, www.overcomersdhministry.blogspot.ca, and you can always email to us overcomersdhm@gmail.com. overcomersdhm@gmail.com. Thank you very much. God bless you so much. See you tomorrow midnight, the same time. I love you so much. There's nothing I can do about it. I love you. Jesus loves you. So there's nothing I can do about it. Thank you. Bye.